architects do really important work. We design buildings that everyone in the world ends up living in, going to school in, working in. But there's this weird tension between how accessible what we make is and the way that we talk about it. And there's a history in architecture of using really big words, wearing all black, as I am currently, and kind of alienating people, pushing people away from really getting involved with what we're doing and understanding the thinking behind it. There's an opportunity to change that, to change really decades, even centuries of architectural history. And that's the fundamental shift in media that's going on with social media. Social media, the iPhone, the smartphone in your pocket, gives everybody a chance to be an architectural photographer. And as they're taking those pictures, they're finding access points into architecture. They're telling their friends that they visited this cool building. They're telling their friends that they should be interested in whatever building that is. So what's starting to happen is you're seeing people craving innovation. They're craving unique places. They want architects to challenge them. They don't want to travel to Vancouver and have it look exactly like the buildings in New York. That's a huge opening for us. It's a chance to start experimenting, and through that experimentation, find new ways to actually dialogue with the public. I don't think that architects should complain about anything ever. Everything is an opportunity. If the world doesn't understand that we should be building green buildings, it's not the world's fault, it's our fault for not finding the convincing argument to get them to realize it. So there seems to be this trend in North America going around kind of, please build a green building, please go for LEED. I don't think that's right. I think we have to find, for instance, the lifestyle around green living, which is compelling, which is sellable, and that's a compelling argument for our developers. So the argument and the product market fit of what we're selling and to whom we're selling it needs to be something that's part of our job. It's not enough to know the right answer. You have to get people to believe in the right answer. The speed of information has been moving faster and faster and faster. What that means is that people can consume buildings in different ways. This hit a crescendo with the Guggenheim Bilbao in 1997. The internet was still nascent, but what happened is that this building so awed everybody, academics and lay people and architects, that the media galvanized around it and taught us the public that this is an important building, that these forms are important. So because of that, all of a sudden everybody wanted those forms and they became kind of ubiquitous throughout the world. And that became the Starkitect movement. But that's great, because then media continued to speed up, the internet happened, smartphones happened, and now everyone can be a Starkitect. Architizer has been really a case study in how to tell people about architecture. We started the platform, architects uploaded their work, and no one came, because we realized that we needed to contextualize architecture. So creating stories, creating learning from sites like BuzzFeed, like Gawker. How are media sites talking about their information? Let's talk about it the exact same way at Architizer. That's grown into a huge million, millions and millions of social media followers. And with that, with this huge community of architects and architecture fans, we're now moving into businesses that help architects do their jobs better.